Historically, the fact that this property is called .prototype has been very confusing for people learning JavaScript. By using this word to describe the methods container object that's available on every function, JavaScript introduces an ambiguous second meaning for the word prototype. So, if someone says object1's prototype is object2, a reasonable interpretation would be to think that failed lookups on this first object should fall through to the second one. So, you might say Amy's prototype is car.prototype. But this is not the relationship that car has with car.prototype. In that case, car is a function object, and failed lookups on it will fall through to some function prototype, where all function objects delegate their failed lookups. The car function's relationship with car.prototype is very different from the one that Amy has with car.prototype. This other relationship reflects the second interpretation of the statement, object1's prototype is object2. The relationship is that when a car function runs, it will create objects that delegate their failed lookups to car.prototype. So in this sense, you might say, car's prototype is car.prototype. So to review, saying Amy's prototype is car.prototype means something very different from saying car's prototype is car.prototype, even though those sentences look so similar. We can leave this discussion behind, but be aware that it's extremely easy to conflate these two uses of the word prototype, and it's well worth investing extra thought in ironing out exactly what the differences between the two uses are.